Hello all, welcome to this course on computer organization. The topics we will be seeing today are multi-cycle data path for R-type and BEQ instruction. Let's begin. For an R-type instruction, the instruction is fetched and the two source registers are read from the register file. ALU-SRCB, the 2-bit control signal for SRCB multiplexer, is used to choose register B as the second source register for ALU. ALU then performs the appropriate operation and stores the result in ALU out. On the next step, ALU out is written back to the register file specified by the RD field of the instruction, bits 11 to 15. This requires two new multiplexers. The mem2reg select line decides whether WD3 comes from either ALU out for an R-type instruction or from data for a load instruction. The regdst select line selects whether the destination register is specified either in the RT field bits 16 to 20 or RD field bits 11 to 15 of the instruction. Now let's see the multi-cycle data path for DEQ. In this MIPS assembly code, you can see that the format of a BEQ consists of two registers and a target label value. So BEQ is a branch when equal instruction. This means that if the value of these two registers are equal, then the target will give you the number of instruction you need to skip in order to reach the new destination. So in the case of this BEQ instruction, instruction is again fetched and two source registers are read from the register file. To determine whether these registers are equal, ALU subtracts these registers and upon a zero result, it sets the zero flag. So in this case, the value of ALU control will be 110 because a subtraction is taking place then. Meanwhile, the data path must compute the next value of PC dash if the branch is taken. So PC dash will be given by PC plus 4 plus the sign immediate value multiplied by 4. Now, why sign immediate value is multiplied by 4? As you can see from the format and from the code, sign immediate value here will give you the number of instructions you need to skip in order to reach the new destination. Since we need to know the number of bytes required there, we will multiply that value by 4. And by 4? Because here we are considering a 32-bit architecture, so each instruction will contain 4 bytes. In the case of a single cycle processor, yet another added was needed to compute the branch address. However, in the case of a multi-cycle processor, ALU can be reused again to save hardware. On one step, ALU computes the value of PC plus 4 and writes it back to the program counter. On another step, ALU uses this updated PC value to compute that PC plus sign immediate multiplied by 4. The sign immediate value is left shifted by 2 to multiply it by 4. Now the SRCB multiplexer will choose this value and adds it to the program counter here. This sum represents the destination of the branch and is stored in ALU out. A new multiplexer controlled by PCSRC chooses which signal should be sent to PC dash. The program counter should be written either when PC write is asserted or when a branch is taken. A new control signal branch indicates that the BEQ instruction is being executed. The branch is taken if 0 is also asserted. Hence, the data path computes the new PC write enable also known as PCEN, which is true either when PC write is asserted or when both branch and zero are asserted. So this completes the design of a multi-cycle MIPS processor data path. Thank you. Thank you for listening.